Hi, welcome to the music show. I'm Ray Braselton, your host.
And I am Nick Rita, co-host.
And today we had Brian Ayers on our show. And
wonder if anybody remembers Brian Ayers.
I think they might. We had them, Brian and his group, Blue Jimmy, on the show.
Right.
Oh, geez, 3 years ago, maybe 4 years ago, right. Something like that. And he was actually one of the first people, him and his group, Blue Jimmy, on the show.
I think Suzanne was saying it was like the fourth show
that
we did was Blue Jimmy.
So that was a long time ago.
Yeah.
But he's now doing a solo act for us, for our show. Mm-hmm. He's entertaining us in a solo concert, I guess you could call
it. He still does the Blue Jimmy.
Yes, he does,
to make that
definitely.
Clear.
And this soloist work he does, he is able to really, I think he's able to get his songs out, his originals that he writes out, probably a little bit more in depth the way he wants them. Mm-hmm. And he's able to work with them a little bit more. I found it remarkable for a solo act to come up here and just captivate me, and I assume you will be captivated by this this performance also.
He does some originals, and he does a couple cover.
Yeah.
He does a John Prine tune. I've always liked John Prine.
Now, John Prine is from?
John Prine is from
all over
the Midwest.
The world. Yeah.
Scarecrow, he's a little bit over
exactly.
here, a little bit over there. No. John Prine's a national act, he's been around for quite a while.
Of course, we'll be having all our other segments, and that includes Uncle Nick's Corner
things,
and
the Showcase.
The Showcase, which is going to be interesting. We're going to be talking about the different types of acoustic pickups. You'll like that because he's actually going to show you three on it.
Has three on his guitar. He uses just the two.
Yeah,
mostly, and then the other is
but he's
the
able
original
to mix
one.
Them too.
Yeah,
the two.
Yeah, it's, you'll find
you'll
that
hear about
pretty
it.
Interesting. Yeah, especially if you have any inclination that you need to use any pickups, this will give you a good overview on the different kinds. So then we'll have our interview and the Uncle Nick's Corner
roundtable. So you'll enjoy the show. Mm-hmm. Stick in there and hold on to your seat.
Hello, everybody. I'm Brian Ayers. I'm here on The Music Show. Working all day for a mean little guy with a bad toupee and a soup-stained tie. He's got me running around the office like a dog around a track. When I get back home, you're always there to rub my back. Hey, Julie, look what they're doing to me, trying to trip me up, trying to wear me down. Julie, I swear it's so hard to bear it, and I'd never make it through without you around. No, I'd never make it through without you around. I catch myself staring into space, counting down the hours till I get to see your face. Hey, Julie, look what they're doing to me, trying to trip me up, trying to wear me down. Julie, I swear it's so hard to bear it, and I'd never make it through without you around. No, I'd never make it through without you around. Why did it come to be? You and I must be away from each other every day. Why must I spend my time filling up my mind with facts and figures that never add up anyway? They never add up anyway. Dribble on a wheel. He can tell me what to do, but he can tell me how to feel. Hey, Julie, look what they're doing, trying to trip me up, trying to wear me down. Julie, I swear it's so hard to bear it, and I'd never make it through without you around. Hey, Julie, look what they're doing to me, trying to trip me up, trying to wear me down. Julie, I swear it's
Welcome everybody to the music show. I'm Ray Braselton, your host, and today we have for you Brian Ayers. And Brian, how you doing?
I'm doing great, good. Ray. Want to thank you for having me on the show today.
Yeah, and good job so far.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I want you to know that Brian, you're from the upstate area, right?
I am.
Right.
Yep.
And I know you do a lot of different originals. You sing a lot of originals, and you do covers. Right? And you play, of course, you play quite a bit. I assume I know you do have other things you do besides just playing music for a living, but that's what your focus is these days, I assume.
Sure, yeah. Well, my focus is on many different things, but but music is much more so these days than it has been lately.
The past 20 years or so.
Sure, past 20 years. And that's about how long it's been, too.
Well, I know I had a couple questions for you, being that you are here. I thought I should be prepared, so I wrote down a few. How long have you been playing guitar and singing out?
Probably out publicly about 20 years.
I had about right.
Yeah, that's true. Probably right after high school, I guess. I graduated in 1989 and started with a high school band like most musicians do.
Yeah, you get the rock and roll and all
Sure. But then I found myself drifting more into the acoustic guitar, singer-songwriter genre. It really suits me well, and I just pursued it.
Well, that's one of the questions that I know that some of the songs you sing, at least to me, I would tend to call them folk, but I don't know what you would call them. But they tell a lot of stories, and that's what I think I enjoy about your music is the stories in them. Would you say that, or
it's interesting that you say that, because sometimes I don't think my songs are enough of a story.
Oh,
maybe they're a little too vague. But if you get a story out of it, that's great. But if that's what folk music is, then I guess that's what I am, a folk artist. It seems to fit me well.
And well, the music you write for it is not folk sounding to me. It's more maybe pop folk or something. I don't know.
Sure.
What would you call it? There's no name for it.
There's a genre out now called Americana, and that's become
very
popular. It's kind of a mix of blues and folk and soul
it covers an awful
music.
Great
it does, and, area, it, and it's almost like a melting pot when you have something you don't really know where to categorize
it.
It's Americana.
Yeah, that's
I'll throw myself into that bag.
But I thought American folk would be what I'd say.
Sure, yeah.
So that was one of the questions I had for you. I also was kind of concerned about how does it feel to be performing solo. I know you work with a group. As a matter of fact, I wanted to talk to you about that.
Sure.
But how does it feel to perform solo? What's the difference between performing solo like you do as opposed to performing with a band?
Sure. Well, I think obviously there's more of a workload when I'm performing by myself. You know, I'm responsible for the song front to back, and there is no taking a breather in the middle of the song or whatnot.
Sure.
But it certainly does allow for a lot more freedom of expression. If I feel the need to take a song in a certain direction, I don't have to worry about everybody else following my lead. I can just I can just do it, and that's very, very nice.
Yeah. Well, even maybe your loudness, how loud and soft you go, you can work
dynamics.
With the mics. The dynamics and the fermatas and all that.
Certainly, I think a lot of venues that I enjoy playing are better suited to a small group. I've played lots of rock and roll clubs, and they're great and they're fun. But there's a whole bunch of other like coffee houses and small little pubs that I enjoy very much, and it's much better suited to a single or a duo act. And so the ability to play all kinds of venues in any format I might choose, it's a luxury for me.
Yeah.
It really is.
Yeah, I know that you started 20 years ago, but did anybody have any influence on you for starting with guitar and singing and all that? Did you have brothers or?
I do. I have a younger brother, and he actually started playing at a younger age than I did. But we both had different circles of friends, and so he
usually that's the case. But
he became an influence later in life, probably in the mid '90s. We started playing together in Blue Jimmy, and I can sing with a lot of people, and I can harmonize with a lot of people. But there's something about his voice and my voice; they just blend in a way that I can't find it with anybody else, and I don't have to let him know what I'm doing. He can just feel it, and I can play off him, and he can play off me, and there's really something to be said for that.
Yeah. Well, but that's a group that you played with for quite a while, Blue Jimmy, and I know you guys play. You know, is there a difference in the music between the solo music you do, or do you incorporate a lot of your music, your solo stuff, into the Blue Jimmy?
Sometimes, if it's suitable and people feel that it fits. My solo stuff is very much American folk, like you say. It's very James Taylor, it's very Jim Croce. Blue Jimmy tends to be kind of a chameleon, and we've put out albums that are rock and roll, we've put out straight country albums, we've put out folk albums, we've done salsa, we've done big band.
Yeah. Well, as a matter of fact, as Blue Jimmy, or just you yourself, have you done some openings for some big acts? I heard you had.
We have, in the past.
Can you tell us a few of those?
As a solo act, I've worked with the Beach Boys, worked with Michael Bolton. I actually opened up for Howie Mandel.
Did you really?
I did in where was that? It was in Pennsylvania, Erie, Pennsylvania. Opened up for Howie Mandel, and I actually got heckled that show. It was a comedy act, and the crowd wants to hear comedy and hear this folk guy gets up and plays. And I got heckled, and I stormed off stage. I wasn't happy about it. Bet. And Howie grabbed me, and he says, "Don't worry about it. I get it all the time." I said, "You do." And he says, "Yeah, that's why I'm going into television." Yeah. Next thing you know, Deal or No Deal.
Right? No kidding. Yeah. Oh, that's great.
Yep.
Well, look, I wanted to ask you real quick for information to get a hold of you as a solo actor or otherwise.
Sure.
What contact information can you give us?
You can always go to bluejimmy.com. That website has a number of email addresses. You can go to a booking email address, and I'll get it, or some of my cohorts will get it, and get right back to you. That's a good way to get a hold of me.
Well, it sounds like we got a little bit more work to do today. You're not off the hook yet, so we're looking forward to having you play a little bit more for us. So everybody, I hope you enjoy the interview. Enjoy Brian here. Stay tuned, and we'll get on with the show.
Thanks, Ray.
See you in a bit.
This song is a great little song by a greatest singer-songwriters I think there are out there today. John Prine. Mr. Prine, if you're out there, I hope I do it justice. It's called Fish and Whistle. I've been thinking lately about the people I meet, the caution on the corner and the hole in the street, the way my ankles hurt with shoes on my feet, and I'm wondering if I'm gonna see tomorrow. Father, forgive us for what we must do. You forgive us and we'll forgive you. We'll forgive each other till we both turn blue, and a whistle and go fishing into heaven. I was in the army, but I never dug a trench. I used to bust my knuckles on a monkey ranch. I'd go on to town and drink and give the girls a pinch, but I don't think they ever even noticed me. Father, forgive us for what we must do. You forgive us, we'll forgive you. We'll forgive each other till we both turn blue, and whistle and go fishing into heaven. Fishing and a whistle, whistle and a fish. Eat everything that they put on your dish. When you get through, we'll make a big wish that we never have to do this again, again, again. Oh, my very first job, I said thank you and please. It made me scrub a parking lot down on my knees. And then I got fired for being scared of bees, and they only gave me 50 cents an hour. Father, forgive us for what we must do. You forgive us, we'll forgive you. We'll forgive each other till we both turn blue. We'll whistle and go fishing into heaven. Fishing and a whistle and a fish. Eat everything that they put on your dish. And when they get through, we'll make a big wish that we never have to do this again. Again, again. Father, forgive us for what we must do. You forgive us and we'll forgive you. We'll forgive each other till we both turn blue, and a whistle and go fishing into heaven. Whistle and go fishing into heaven. Whistle and go fishing into heaven.
Hello, and welcome to Uncle Nick's Corner for the Uncle Nick's Corner segment, the educational part of the program. Sometimes we feel like public TV. Today, I'd like to go over a simple chord solo on the song Autumn Leaves. Now, I've
done a few things with this song before. If you've heard some of the other things, we did a chordal analysis, a harmonic analysis of it, and we also done a more fancy, if you will, chord solo based on it. But today what I'd like to do is just take this simple melody and just add a few simple chords. This is how we start out working on chord solos. And chord solos are such a good way to learn the guitar, because we start looking at chords in respect to the notes that are in the chords, and the melody in respect to the chords that are harmonized with it. So we're looking at note reading, we're looking at interpreting chords, but we're also looking at harmonic content. We're also looking at theoretical things. But let's get started. As we said before, the Autumn Leaves is in the key of G, and it has an F sharp in it. Now, when we read music on guitar, we read it an octave lower. We play it an octave lower than it's actually read. For instance, when we play this C that's on the third space of the staff, we're actually sounding middle C, which if we were to write it in its actual pitch, it would be the first ledger line below the staff. So that's one thing that we contend with as we're playing guitar. So what I'm going to do is read this and play this as we would normally play the transposed octave. Starts out with an E, F sharp, G, C. Now when we get to that C chord, I want to put a chord into there. And the chord that it says on the sheet music is A minor 7. I'm just going to play an A minor. The A minor chord, we know in the first position, it's A, E, A, C, E. This C right here is the melody note that we want. So what we're going to do, and we can do that however we want. We can play, or we can play however we want, just combining the chord with that note. Then we're going to a D7 chord, and there I'm just going to iterate. I like that word, iterate the chord. I'm just going to play the chord and announce the chord, and then I'm going to play the, that would be D, E, F sharp, B. Now the chord that goes with that B is a G major 7. I'm just going to play a G chord for now. Now the G chord that we play in the first position, G, B, D, G, B, G, but notice this G right here is the G that we're going to be playing in the melody. So I'm going to do the same thing with that, playing the chord so the top note is the melody note. Let's review that. Then the next chord is a C major 7. Then is a melody that goes with that. Now we can put chords in with that, but I wanted to simplify this. There's the next note, A. The chord is an F sharp minor 7 with a flat 5. Well, we're not going to play that whole thing. All I'm going to do is I'm going to put an F sharp below the A to add some interest. And then we're going to go to a B7. And the melody, B, C sharp, D, G. When we get to that G chord, or that G note, the chord is an E minor. The E minor chord that we play in the first position is E, B, E, G, B, E. But that G right there is the melody note. So to bring us to that point, we have thank you. I played D sharp should be to the G. Now you can see the chord solo start to develop. Obviously, you can put different chords in different places. If we were doing this a little bit more on the advanced level, what we would do is put it up an octave higher. Let me do that again. Now that was the E, F sharp, G to the C, putting an A minor 7 way up there. So the concepts that we're looking at here, we would use even as we go up the fingerboard. To finish this off, from the second ending, now we're going to go to the chorus, D sharp, E. That's an F sharp minor 7, flat 5 chord, but I'm just going to play the melody there. There's the E minor with a G up on top. A minor to the G again, this time with the B on top. And now we're going to play a F minor 7 flat 5, but I'm going to substitute an A minor there with the C on top. And now I'm going into a E minor with the B on top. And then I'm going to go to a C. Now this is an interesting thing. I'm playing a C chord, but the top note needs to be an A, so I'm, instead of playing, I'm going to put the A on top. And there you have it in the first position. Very simple, but we're using concepts that will be used later as you grow in your ability to play these chord solos. I think, again, that's a good way to start studying and understanding harmony and theory and how things fit together in the scheme of things. So again, if you have any questions or any comments, anything, just give a call. You can email, snail mail, phone, whatever, and we'll answer any question you would have. So until next time, we'll be seeing you.
Here's a number off the latest Blue Jimmy album called South Ave Sessions. It's called Round and Round. Waiting to see you, waiting for a time when I can be near you. I hope you're not as far away as you seem. Wanna keep going, this would be a good time to show it. I think I need something to believe. Round and around, baby, time and again, wondering how and where and when. Win or lose, I'm gonna try it again and again. 'Cause love's a decision, doesn't always arrive with perfect precision. It only comes around every once in a while. Some women are jaded, some are just a little bit too complicated. But all I see in you is a smile. Some folks say that it's too far to go. I know there's so much that I don't know. So much inside, but there's only so much I can show. We go round and around, maybe time and again, wondering how and where and when. Win or lose, we'll try it again and again. I will come home to you in a day or two, and I'll be with you again.
never have to worry about where I've been. We go around and around every time and again, wondering how and where and when. Win or lose, I'll try it again and again. I wonder how, I'll try it again and again, yeah. Try it again and again. Do-do-do-do,
Can you hear him playing? Can you hear it? Well, we're going to have Brian now give us a little bit of an instrument showcase on different pickups, acoustic guitar pickups. And so, Brian, thank you for joining us again.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
And we're going to, I wanted to ask you a few questions on the pickups on the guitar. This is, I don't know if it's unique, because I think I've seen other people do it.
Sure.
But three pickups on guitar is a little bit unique. One's kind of a backup on the guitar, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe, Brian, if you don't know, and everybody met Brian Ayers, I'm sure everybody's met him already, seeing you play and everything. So why don't you tell us a little bit what you got in this? First of all, you got a Martin guitar.
I do.
That's a very nice guitar. The Martins are known to be one of the best guitars. Yeah. This particular guitar, I guess you got outfitted with a, what would you call this, magnetic, is it?
Yeah, it's a sound hole pickup, but the one you referred to that was that is the backup these days is actually the original pickup in the guitar. It came with a Fishman on board, and it's just a piezo pickup underneath the saddle. And that's a pretty standard guitar pickup for direct. And
can you explain what it looks like under the saddle?
It's just a real thin strip of metal that's underneath here, and it requires this preamp right here that's on the inside. That's how the guitar came fitted. It's pretty standard. It's a Fishman. It's a classic four. It offers a little bit of EQ, a little bit of notch, some volume. It is powered. Just take a bit of a battery here, mm-hmm. You can see. And you know, it does the job. It's not a bad pickup as they mm-hmm. go. Mm-hmm. But some people get a little tired of the direct sound,
right.
Especially if you want to record a guitar directly. Not the best way to do it with a pickup like this. The benefit of this is that you're going to reduce your amount of feedback because you're not using a microphone, but yet right. To reproduce the sound of the guitar mm-hmm. In a true manner, you'd want some kind of microphone.
So that's what you got in there, right?
That's what we've got in here. Now we've got I guess this is a piezo. It's very similar to this one here in the sound hole, but also inside, and you probably won't be able to get a shot through the sound hole.
It is going to be hard to see it. Let's hold on 1 second.
Oh, you can kind of see that little black gooseneck.
Can you see anything in there?
On the end of that little black gooseneck is a microphone. It's a condenser mic. It's a hypercardioid pattern, so it tends to reduce unwanted feedback. And I can blend the sound of that mic and the sound of this pickup. I can get the body of the guitar with the microphone and the warmth and the ambience, but yet at the same time I get the clarity and the attack that comes with the piezo.
Now that's a magnetic pickup, right? How's this one work? No?
I believe it's similar, just as similar to this one here.
Very, very, very
similar. It just mounts in the sound hole. Okay. What's nice is that it's not technically a permanent install. I can very easily zip this out of here and pop it in another guitar if I wanted to. It's not a hard install like this one is here.
As far as this pickup that I've seen on others that I've had, I thought they do sell magnetic pickups like that too, don't they?
They do, yeah. There's
right.
a lot of sound hole pickups.
Okay.
And they come in a very inexpensive fashion, and they also come in fairly high quality and more expensive
fashion. So you're saying this is very similar to this one?
I believe the physics are very similar.
The physics
yes.
are, yeah. But this is good. What's the difference between the sound of this pickup and this?
Well, let's find out. It'd be a nice little experiment. Mm-hmm. Right now we've got it wired with the original pickup that was on the guitar. It's these onboard electronics and this saddle pickup. And if we did maybe a little finger picking. And I'm sure you can hear some good solid attack with it, but not too warm, is my guess is what you're hearing.
And that was which pickup?
That was the original pickup. Okay. And just maybe to get some more variety of sound and maybe something a little truer, we'll switch to this newer pickup that's in there. And this is a Fishman Rare Earth in the sound hole here. And what we've got here is just this sound hole, similar to this one, but in the sound hole. It's still direct. But for that warmth, we'll go just to the microphone. Now I can blend those two by this little switch in here.
But we're gonna go just to the microphone?
Now this will be just the mic.
Okay, inside, right.
You should be able to hear this tapping. It's picking up everything in the body there. And or I can go halfway in between. So it offers me more of a variety of sound. The next modification to make with this is to split the output. I put it with it using a stereo jack. Mm-hmm. I could use a stereo jack, and one side of the stereo would be just the pickup. The other side would be just the microphone. So I have an option of where to send those two signals. The real drawback with the microphone and playing live, if you have live monitors, you're subject to feedback now.
Yeah.
But I could, if I split this, I can send the mic just to the house and have no mic in the monitors.
Okay.
Just the sound.
Two things. Would you, if you had the stereo, would you send one microphone into one speaker and another into another speaker, or no? You wouldn't.
No,
do that.
I'd send the same signal to both speakers, but,
okay. But
having
a stereo, sound.
Having two leads
right.
Allows one lead to be the saddle pickup and the other lead to be the microphone, so I can blend and I can, from the mixing board, I can route where they
gotcha.
Go.
Okay,
I
understand now. That's good. That's very good.
It's nice to have the option.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep. Oh, I had another question. I forgot, but. It is the first time we've had an opportunity to have somebody with three different pickups.
Sure.
Would you ever blend the three of them? You probably wouldn't, would
I've
you?
I've never tried. I don't know. You know, some of the craziest things that come out of beautiful recordings and performances come from experimenting like that.
Right.
Why not?
Yeah,
why not? There's. I tend to believe that there's no wrong answer.
Yeah,
so,
okay.
So you might as well. Yeah. You might as well try.
Yeah. Very interesting, Brian. I can't thank you enough for showing us this. I didn't know if there was anything else we could say about it. I think we've covered everything.
It's pretty standard.
Pretty standard. And I guess I was going to ask, like, would there be a particular pickup in there that you would play for a particular type of song more so than the other pickup? That might be a question.
Good question. Never really considered different types of song. Different type of venue, certainly. Mm-hmm. Depending on the venue I'd be playing, mm-hmm. I might drop the mic out altogether and just play with the pickup.
For what reason?
Probably just to reduce the feedback.
Okay.
We've been recording shows live with mm-hmm. a full band, mm-hmm. and if it's just myself on the guitar, mm-hmm. It sounds great. When the band kicks in,
yeah.
All you get from my guitar channel is the band bleeding through the mic.
Oh, boy.
So again, being able to split the pickup in the mic.
Then you can, that's great.
We can choose which track is best when we go to mix down, as well as a live selection. So I think more so than song, I think venue.
Yeah. Well, I think that pretty much answers most of my questions. If you have any more questions, send them to Brian Ayers. I'm sure, Brian, you would probably wouldn't mind answering them,
would be
you?
Happy to. I don't claim to be an expert, but...
why don't you give us your contact information again on that, so in case they did want to.
Look me up at bluejimmy.com, and you can email the booking email address, and I'd be happy to get back to you.
You know, I was going to ask one more question.
Sure.
I don't suppose this would work. You wouldn't put a... Maybe you would. If you only had that one microphone, and then you didn't have the other pickups, you didn't use them.
Mm-hmm.
Could you put, like, what do you call that sound hole cover that made out of rubber?
Like a feedback cluster.
Would that work?
You'd probably lose an awful lot of clarity from the strings. I mean, you'd be isolating the mic,
right.
And I bet you'd sound very, very muffled.
Okay.
Hey,
well,
you know what?
Dumb
you can
questions.
Try. You know, you never. You have toys. You might as well play with them, right? And see what you can come up with.
Well, thanks again, and we'll see you in a little bit.
Thanks.
Okay, keep on chugging there.
You bet.
See you in a big game.
There's a song I wrote a few years back. It's one of my more favorites. It's called Still Here at Home.
I just called you to check in and find out once again what you're doing tomorrow, and will you do it with a friend? And as for me, I don't know. Was thinking maybe I'd see the shore. It's really not so far. It's just a few miles around the bend. Well, how long has it been since I've seen you? You know I'm still here at home. I gave up the TV and the telephone. I'm singing more songs and writing down words. You know I'm better off this way. Getting more out of my days. Will I wait for tomorrow, hoping you'll be here? This is a game I really shouldn't play. It's been so hard on me today. Some days are better than others. You know I've always been this way. Do you ever think of me? And what exactly do you do? I mean, it's so hard not knowing. It's so hard when you don't show it. How long has it been since I've seen you? You know I'm still here at home. I gave up the TV and the telephone. Singing more songs and writing down words. You know I'm better off this way. I'm getting more out of my days. Will I wait for tomorrow, hoping you'll be here? Will I wake up tomorrow and you'll be here? Hard not knowing. It's so hard when you don't show it.
Hi, I'm Ray Braselton, your host of The Music Show.
And I'm Nick Reed, a co-host.
Very happy to have you back with us. We have, of course, Brian Ayers with us. Brian, welcome to our little show.
Thank you very much. Glad, glad to be here.
You are the show, as a matter of fact, come to think about it.
I right? seem to be. I've been in all the segments.
That's so he's here, the Michael Ayers, or Michael, who am I thinking?
Call me Michael, sure.
Brian Ayers' show here. But no, we have, we usually start the show with a question, and kind of the question of the day, question of the week. And this one would be regarding how to promote your original song. What's the best way to promote your original song? Go get a recording contract, find somebody to put you on TV, like The Music Show, or something. What is the best way to promote? And also maybe what you might want to do is in regards to copyright. And I thought, Nick, I think we got Brian next to us, and we told him we wouldn't put it all on him today, but maybe we should put it all on him.
We could.
But we won't.
As he starts talking, we'll probably chime
exactly.
in here and there. So don't worry. Don't worry, Brian. You're not alone.
Since Brian has written so many songs, and how many songs have you written?
I don't know. I recently took all of the music that I have on various CDs and hard drives, and I put them all into one folder. I think between the completed songs and the bits and pieces that I have, I'm pushing 60, 65,
oh,
something like that.
Yeah.
Some I really like, some are horrible. But that's okay. They
that's
need to be, they need
they
to be written.
Be done. You know, the way they used to do it years ago, I don't think pertains today too well, as far as they used to, go in the to the radio stations and push them on the radio stations, your local radio station. But a lot of the local radio stations won't play it anymore unless it's a nationally pushed CD or
They used to give them some money along with the recording.
Well, I did
to make sure that they would play it.
Yes.
Enough time. What was that called? Payola.
Yeah.
Remember that?
Can't get away with that anymore. And of course, one of the things that they still do, and people do today, and I think Hank Williams used to do it. He used to, after he get it on the radio stations, he used to put a bunch of it in the trunk of his car, and go to different places, play it out, and sell his CDs at his. And that is the way people do it today a lot. But there's so much more now. You got your indie labels and everything else that you work with.
Right.
But to promote that label, the indie label, and indie meaning independent label,
right.
To promote it is quite a chore. And yeah. Today probably harder than ever.
Well, the radio's changed an awful lot. In the fact that most of the radio stations that we listen to today, they're owned by one large corporation. You go up and down the dial, and generally the popular stations, they all fall under one corporate umbrella. And it's very hard to get independent music into those large market
right.
stations. So the indie labels will look for smaller, locally owned public access stations, probably much like this one, mm-hmm. that are willing to take a chance on local talent mm-hmm. and really spice up the playlist, mm-hmm. which is nice.
I remember one time we've had a couple people that went through my business and asked me about it, and then later on I found that he did get on some of the radio stations, but he had to get emails sent to the radio station from thousands of people, and he did. He had contacts all over the United States. I think he had a lot of relatives. I don't know what it was. And actually, that pushed that radio station, just those emails, to play his song.
That's great.
So,
And actually, there's a trend going on. We're in the greater Rochester area, and some of the radio stations around here are actually hosting 1 to 3 hour local music
right.
shows once a week.
Yeah.
And it's a start, but it's something that I never saw 10 years ago.
Well, there used to be on, I forget what station it was, Uncle Roger.
Yes.
Homegrown.
Yep.
That was mostly overnight, they
yep.
would. He's passed away.
He did.
Roger died.
He did.
But
yep.
He would play just local talent.
Yeah, and that was, I believe, it was on Sunday nights at 11 o'clock, and
right.
a little before my time. But I can remember listening to it late at night on the radio, and some of the acts that were really big in the Rochester area in the '70s and the early '80s, right. they were all on Uncle Roger's
right.
show.
That's historic.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is historic.
It's a lot different, though, in the sense that they go national as opposed to just this area. So probably some of the ways they do it now, I know they use YouTube a lot. And I've been told, you know, you should really go onto YouTube if you want to push this. And we have some people. You were talking about a girl from Fairport or something that did something on the ukulele.
Sure.
And she just put a few, snippets of scenes or something with it, and played the ukulele, and it went wild all over the country.
Well, I don't know if it's gone wild yet, but she, part of her shtick, Julian Yunes is her name, and I believe she's 19, she's probably 20, 21 now, but she apparently she learned how to play the ukulele, and she wrote a few songs and played a few covers, and she did a great job, some very creative yet simple video editing,
right.
Very entertaining to watch and to listen to, and it just caught on. Her fan base on YouTube grew and grew and grew. I know she got invited to some type of ukulele fest in England. She's played locally here, and as I understand it, she's on tour now.
Yeah. Well, there's been other people like Susan Boyles and that little blonde girl, the little cute girl with the opera voice. That's made it on the internet that way. So any other ideas and ways to promote?
It seems there's no one way to do it.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
I mean, in order to minimize your chances of failure, you got to do a lot of different things.
You bet, and utilize the resources out there. Internet radio has become quite mm-hmm. the rave these days.
Yeah.
A lot of people can start their own radio stations
right.
on the internet right. and stream their music.
Yeah. So there's
the XM radio. I don't know much about that. I was listening to a program the other day, and it was specialized.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I think Dylan actually did some of the announcing on this radio station.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. So, the thing is, I think it becomes more specialized.
Sure. Specific stations for specific genres
right,
of music.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
Yep. And they, as I understand it, cater to a much larger variety and a larger pool of artists than a lot of your traditional FM stations.
Right.
Well, again, well, I just want to thank you for your help on this. This is the question of the day. And if you have any reason to have send us, you know, a mail, email, yeah. or
you have any questions?
Any questions?
Like
you know,
answer.
You just send it we'll to the best. Contact information right. you see right below you now, right. and we'll be glad to try to answer them the best we can with some of the guests we have. So please write in. And wanted to, Brian to make sure we got a few questions answered from you. Okay,
sure.
And I know that you. As a solo artist, you have worked quite a bit with background bands, and particularly with Blue Jimmy.
Yes.
Now, you want to tell us a little bit about Blue Jimmy?
Certainly.
This is kind of well-known to you, this group, and close to your heart, I'm
well,
sure.
Well, we grew up together,
yeah.
and I don't know how much more close you can get than that, but we did. We all graduated from Bloomfield Central School. In anywhere between 1985 and 1996, we all fall, and there's two sets of brothers in the band: myself mm-hmm. and my brother Chad, and Mike and Steve Nelson, who are our rhythm section, and then Greg Afell as well. And we've been together since '83, I think '84, when the three of them guys, when they were in junior high, they put together a little three-piece. I joined them when I was a junior. Chad joined the band, I think, 95, 96. Mm-hmm. So it's been a long time, at least in comparison to a lot of other groups that I know around
that
the area.
That would be pretty unusual,
yes.
that amount of time.
Very
yes,
few groups that I know of have been
survived.
Together that long. So
right.
a lot of groups have been on more tours, they've played more shows, they may have released more albums, but
yeah.
we certainly have longevity.
You sure
that's
do.
That's for sure.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
for sure, and it's a blessing.
Yeah, the group is fantastic, and we've been, we had the group, which you were, of course, a part of back
we'll
one of our first
again.
Shows.
Yeah,
because
it was
on
like
here.
The... One of the first, man. I think the fourth.
Somebody said tonight
right.
it was the fourth.
Right.
Yeah.
So we're really honored to get you back after all this time and everything. I think we're going on our 78th or 79th show. But I guess we were talking a little bit about how the difference in feeling was. I know you're doing a little bit of solo stuff, and how it. We talked a little bit about it earlier on the interview, I believe. But how is the feel as far as like working with yourself alone, how does it really, really affect you differently? Is it something you kind of inspire to? Do you kind of like the idea of doing some spots once in a while, like having your own a concert or by yourself type
sure.
thing? Does that really pop
right,
your head?
Right, yeah. Well, I do enjoy it. And, yeah. and being the front man for that group,
yeah.
It allows me to obviously be backed or go on my own, as I think I alluded to earlier in a different section of the, of
yeah,
the show.
Yeah, yeah.
It just allows me more control over the music.
Mm-hmm. Right.
When we work together as Blue Jimmy, we're very much a democracy.
Yeah.
And that is a good thing because
sure.
everybody brings great ideas to
right.
the table. It doesn't mean you always like everybody's ideas, and that's okay
it's okay
too.
Too right.
But I can be my own little dictator in that way and make all the decisions on my own.
Yeah.
But and it allows me flexibility in the music. I can play different kinds of venues,
yeah.
And also play music that I might not get to play with Blue Jimmy.
Mm-hmm. Right.
There are
right.
certain.
Is there a big difference between the music? Because I know you have a big influence on their music on Blue Jimmy. Is there? Some.
I think there is. If,
okay.
if I'm playing by myself, I tend to go much more of a folk route
mm-hmm.
Than I might otherwise. You only have so much time to rehearse, so
right.
where I might be able to sit by myself
right.
at
sure.
nighttime and learn 2-3 different songs,
right.
that doesn't mean we get to tighten them up as a group. And we're right. not the type of band to just kind of plod through a song and that's good enough for a Saturday night at the bar. Mm-hmm. We tend to want to get it right, and it takes time.
It's I know all about it. It's,
yeah.
it's tough.
Yes.
I wanted to make sure we got out your new CD. I believe mm. this, or yeah, it's a CD.
Sure.
Do you? Is this the whole band, Blue Jimmy?
It is.
Okay. I don't know if you can get a picture of this. It's on the round table there. But this is Blue Jimmy, and what's the name of this CD?
The name of the CD is South Ave Sessions, and it's put out in 2008, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not terribly
new.
But it's our most recent, and
yeah.
it's there's the five of us there. South Avenue, I used to own a house on South Avenue in Bloomfield, which we played at, practiced at.
Did you live in a bar? No, I'm kidding.
No, but I would.
You would if you could.
It's a beautiful barn.
Oh boy.
But it's named after our rehearsal studio. Yeah. What it was at that time.
Oh,
so,
that's neat.
But it's got a lot of different kinds of music on it. A lot of people are classifying it as a country album, mm-hmm. And there are certainly some country songs on there. But there's a little bit of rock. There's a little bit of folk. It's a nice album. It really is. Easy to listen to. Good songs.
I know your group plays all over Rochester. I can't remember where I came to see you. That little
Monty's
place.
Crown.
Was that Monty's Crown? He remembers where I went.
I do.
I'm glad somebody
Monroe
does.
Monroe and East.
Monroe, right at 490.
Yeah.
There's Monty's Quarter.
Yes.
Okay. And then this is Monty's Crown.
Well, this is where I saw you. And boy, you'll play for thousands of people, mm-hmm. or you'll play for five people in the room.
Or we'll play for. That's very much a rock and roll bar.
Yeah.
And kind of a heavy rock and roll bar. But yet at the same time, we can go into something that's much more of a pub, or we can go into much more of a dance hall. And Blue Jimmy is versatile like that. Mm-hmm. We're not pigeonholed into one genre. We can cater our set list to different rooms, and I think that's kind of why we have survived as long as we have, because we can adapt.
Yeah, you sure can. And the music, the harmony that you guys put in there, the strong, you know, you're real tight, I guess is the only word I got for it, the tightness
Thank
of it.
You.
You're supposed to be going like that to
Thank
me.
You.
Now.
That's great. Cut it.
She's
cut
after
it.
Me to cut it. So everybody, we do have to, I want to thank you again and for being on the show. It was great to see this solo act, and I do want to see you either at the Auditorium Theater or on PBS, you know, or something like that, doing your concert. And I'm going to be able to say, I know this guy. I touched him.
I'll try to help you out, Ray.
Call me. Yeah. So
free tickets and everything.
Yeah.
You bet.
Yeah.
You bet. You bet. We'll get you into the green room and everything.
Right.
Wow. Certainly, yes.
What's the green room? I don't know. I'll show you later. Okay.
So everybody, from Uncle Nick and Brian myself, we wish you a good day.
Good
Thank you, Brian. And,
Thank you.
Stay tuned or watch. Keep a watch out for our next show coming up next week. This very same channel. Bye.
Like the way we are, we're so close but still so far. I wanna pull you back to me. I don't like the way it sounds, it's so quiet 'cause you're not around. I wanna hear you talk to me. You took my hand. You took my hand. You took my hand, got me crawling on that hand, and both my knees. You got me crawling on that hand, and both my knees. You know I'm not a man who's always able to understand. It comes and goes from day to day. Some things will never change. I'll never leave. I will always say I'm with you. Come with me. You took my hand. You took my hand. You took my hand. Got me crawling on that hand and both my knees. You've got me crawling on that hand and both my knees. Someday down the road, you'll look around at the seed you've sown. I'll be there, don't be surprised, staring straight into your eyes. You took my hand. You took my hand. You took my hand.
got me crawling. Well, I'm crawling on hands and knees. I'm crawling on that hand and both my knees. You took my hand and I'm crawling. I'm crawling on hands and knees. I'm crawling on that hand and both my knees.
You're watching Public Access Television for Western New York.